Hello everyone, it's Vicky and I'm here today because I have a package for all of you, and this is a new traveler's notebook, okay? But not only is it a new traveler's notebook, it's also coming from a new company, one I have never heard of, that reached out to me and asked if I'd be interested in doing a review for them. Now, I took a look at the website, I was looking around, and I thought, these look really kind of familiar. They look a little similar to some other companies. And so I asked, I think it's fair to ask, and I also, I'm gonna make a statement with the fact that I think there can never be enough people who create traveler's notebooks. There can never be enough people who are out there. I think there's plenty of room for all of us and for everyone to have business. But I have to say this because I think many of you will see the similarities, that they look like Naked Cow or Journals by Joey. And so when I asked the owner, hey, do you know of this person? He responded and said, yeah, he's his nephew. So if you guys are familiar with Naked Cow and kind of the look of some of those, and I'm not saying that everything is the same, it's just that it reminded me a lot of Naked Cow or Journals by Joey. If you guys know, I've had a lot of wonderful unboxings here on YouTube. So it is in its envelope here, it's just cut. And so I wanna show you the packaging because I almost had a heart attack when I saw this. I love packaging. If you guys know me, you know I love packaging. And the little leather piece here is Taiwan, like the country, and it also says Taiwan on there. It's got cute little tags. They even have washi, and this is like a beautiful like wax bag that I'm obsessed with. I absolutely love it. So I thought, why not? Let's open it together. Let's see what we've got, and then you guys give me your thoughts and your opinions. The company's name is LeCow. It's an uppercase L, a lowercase E, and then an uppercase C-O-W. So LeCow is the name. They're coming from Taiwan, and I can't wait to look at the work. Like, some of the things that really stood out to me were that the leathers are like that really nice high quality leather. There's also something really interesting that has like a patchwork, like a leather kind of patchwork look to it, that I really found very intriguing as well. But I'll show you guys what my little wish list request was. Okay, so here we are, a camera down, so you can see and get a better kind of feel for this beautiful packaging. I admire packaging. I have to spend some time always with packaging because that's how obsessed I am with packaging. So I like the twine. I love the little cards. This little touch, I have not seen any traveler's notebook company come up with, to have a little charm made of the country in a beautiful piece of leather. I think that's a really awesome, sweet touch. And I just love the advertising on here. So this is LeCow, and we have the Etsy shop here. There's also a great Facebook group. There's a fair bit of people already in the group there, so if you want to join and take a look and see kind of the work that is already there. And then, like I mentioned, this comes in a really beautiful bag. I love this like wax bag. You can see it's shiny. And then on the back, look, there's LeCow. They have their own washi tape. Isn't that awesome? I love that they have their own washi tape. So I'm gonna try and see if I can pull that up. Here we go. And then we can just open the bag without having to tear anything, because I definitely want to use this. And oh, here we go. Da, 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 da. Can you hear the angels singing? OMG is all I can say. OMG. So this has an elastic around here, but if you noticed, it's not attached to the notebook, because I asked for something that was more in a folio style. I love this. It says true love lasts forever. It's a beautiful lightweight, like kind of little wooden disc. And I love that it just comes around, but I don't have to use it if I don't want to. If you guys have been watching me for a little while now, you know that I've kind of been pulling all the elastics out of my traveler's notebooks and using them mainly as folios. Inside, oh my God. I gotta breathe. Give me a second here, folks. This is my very, very, very first time seeing this. So, whew, my heart is like, I'm getting hot. I'm having flashes. Like, this is so beautiful. Red is such a vibrant and appealing color to me. It's so like, it could be love or it can be evil. It could be hate. It could be like, I love red. Red is so beautiful. Oh my God. Okay. Hold on, let me do that again. This is This is so beautiful. This is such a beautiful, rich, gorgeous red. I'm gonna give you some comparison leathers so that you can get an idea, including Cherry Ice. I will give you that from the Naked Cow. It's so stunning. It feels so luxe, so soft. The smell is intoxicating. I could get drunk from this smell. It's so beautiful, so wonderful. It's nice and flippity floppity as we're doing this. Inside of here, it looks like we get a beautiful coaster of the a leather that is not this one. It's a red one, but it's a beautiful kind of coaster. I use these on my desk and my coffee table all the time. I have a couple of them from other companies, and I love using these on my desk. It's a great smell in your office as well. So a little note, which is so nice, and then a few tips for taking care of it. So avoid prolonged exposure to the sun. The sun will deepen the color of the leather like a suntan. Never use harsh chemicals to clean. Never use petroleum jelly. Moisturize your notebook about every 3 months. Thank you so much for supporting my store. It's from Diamond. This is just thanks for your warm-hearted and wish this cherry ice. So this is cherry ice also. We'll make you surprise. I trust with your powerfully support. Absolutely. They're a small company. And I think that they deserve some absolute love. These got shipped very quickly. And look at these beautiful floating pockets. So I did ask for everything that you see here. So when I asked, I told him that I wanted this to be more of a folio. So I did not want the elastic in here. Inside, what I said was on the left-hand side, I wanted these like floating pockets, which I adore. These, by the way, do not get in the way of things, and I'll share with you why in just a second. We get some extra elastic in here, which is really, really nice. So you can replace your elastic inside of here. And then we have these beautiful floating pockets. So this one pocket on this side, and something that's really unique too to mention, is this doesn't go all the way to the top. So you have a nice little pocket here that doesn't go all the way to the top. I really like that. I love these little pockets here because you can, if you see, there's some separations here, so you can put actually cards in here, cards in here, cards in here, like business cards or something else that you want to hold in there. And this one is just a nice little pocket, so you can throw something small in there. The reason why I chose with going with this type of a pocket, more of a secretarial pocket in the front, is because I tend to flip this one a bit more than the one here in the back. So when I have cards, like credit cards or business cards or anything like that in the front one, they tend to fly out a little bit more easily than they do if they're in a secretarial. So this is why I chose this version. The elastic in here is a must for me. Once I saw that elastic can be put in here, it's a must. And I'll show you how I use these in just a second, but these are required for me. You can choose all of your stitching. You can choose your ribbons and your elastics. All of it's customizable. On this side here, I went with a beautiful pocket of like just business card type of pockets in here. The reason for that is this is cute for ephemera. It's cute for business cards. It's cute for you to put any of that little like bits and bobs you want to put in here. Again, being that it's in the back here, it stays more safe. It's just like when you open up a notebook, everything flies out of this one. So I figured with the secretary, it's a little easier. And then on the back here, things don't tend to fly out that much. That was my thought process with that. Then we have another elastic in here, which is absolute perfection. I love it. We did get a notebook, and the notebook is really nice. It has nice white paper and nice perforations on here, which you don't see very often in notebooks, but I love to have perforated pages because if you're using this to just jot down notes or sketch notes, it's nice to be able to tear something out if you really need it. So the way that I love using notebooks like this style, and this is also in the A5 size, so you can work with any kind of size range that you want to. He'll customize. They're super responsive. So if you're worried about response time or wait times or anything like that, they're a brand new company, guys. So get your hands on them. If you order, you're going to get them really fast. They're brand new, so they're not hit with tons and tons of orders. So they're going to come really quick. Just want to highlight that. So when I use notebooks like this, I like to have them open flat. There's nothing more that drives me nuts than when I can't open a notebook flat. So when I'm working in here, the floating pocket is going to open all the way, and then I use this elastic to hold the page down. If I'm writing on this page, right, so I'm going to open it up all the way, and if I'm writing on the left-hand side or even on the right-hand side, I'm obviously not going to write with the elastic in the way. So what I tend to do is I will flip it to like a couple of pages, and then go back to where I was, and then it doesn't up, the elastic isn't in the way. If you're using a board to write on, like if you're in a Hobonichi or a Tomoe River paper, if you put the board behind it, it won't matter that you have the elastic there. But this is how I tend to do it, because I don't always use a board to write on. I'll just go to like the front cover or something, and then it doesn't obstruct when I'm writing on here. And I'll do it for this side as well. But it keeps my notebooks nice and open and nice and flat, and I love it. And I'm pretty sure this is gonna be my 2019 Hobonichi cover. I've been waiting for this, not very patiently, but I have, because I've just been so excited. I've just been hounding my poor mail lady, waiting for this to come. It only really took like a week or a week and a half. It came very quickly. I mean, Diamond's really good about getting it to you very fast. But I mean, how stunning is this? It is absolutely beautiful. The website's very easy to navigate. And like I mentioned, a couple of things that really stood out to me, obviously, was this red, because I love red, but the patchwork leather may be on my wish list. That might be my next one. I love that like patchwork leather that he's got going on. It's really cool. There's also, you can choose different closures. I did not choose a closure. I kind of just like the idea of the folio. It primarily remains on my desk, but I've seen Life with Mitts. Mitts had on hers a really beautiful closure. It was kind of like almost like a button closure that you had on there. So you have some options with your closures. You can have like magnetic closures. There's a lot to look through. So I recommend taking your time, but I also recommend, it's a new company, get your hands on it, and then you can get this stuff a lot more quickly. So to compare, I'm gonna give you a couple of other notebooks that are red that I own to give you a comparison. Okay, so here we go. Here's some fun with reds. This red is a beautiful, beautiful red Yael leather from Rowena and Sojourner. This is absolutely stunning. I love this notebook so much, and this was really kindly gifted to me by Rowena, and I love it. The leather in these two, so color wise this one is a little bit more of a brick red. This one has a little bit more cherry, which makes sense because it's cherry ice. This has a little bit more of that deeper, richer kind of red. This is a little bit brighter leather texture. So if you're familiar with this leather, this is just so soft and plush. This is also very soft, but it has a little bit more texture to it. And I believe that with time, it'll definitely get very, very, very soft. This I've had for quite a while, so I think it's gained that, but this is definitely a much more kind of softer, more pliable leather, where this guy has a little bit more structure to it, but still very, very soft. The next one that I have is my Cherry Ice from Naked Cow. If you guys remember, I did have an unboxing of this guy when it first came out. It's a very luxurious leather. They're very similar, but the grain is a little bit different. So the red on this Cherry Ice is a little bit different than the red on this one. This has a little bit more of a deeper red. This one has a little bit more of that lighter red. But the pebbling on this leather is a little different than it is on this leather. And it may, I mean, they look very, very similar, but I'm just saying what I see in person. Now, obviously, I have contrasting stitching. That's my personal choice. I just wanted to kind of go with the same. But the grain on this has a much more pebblier type of a look to it. This has just a different kind of hide. The leather on this is relatively squishy, as well as this one. This one's a little floppier and mushier, and I mean mushier in a good way. Very, very plush than this one. This one definitely has a little bit more structure, you know, to it than this guy. This is a little bit more plush, but you can see that there's definitely some similarities. I do have floating pockets in that one as well, but I did want to give you a fair comparison in case you did own a Cherry Ice from, this is still when it was Naked Cow, but it's Journals by Joey currently. And then last but not least, I do want to give you a red color comparison with a Kate Spade. So this is a Kate Spade in the red. It's one of my absolute favorite planners. I love this red so much. It's just like that perfect cherry red lipstick. And so I just want to give you a comparison of what kind of that red looks like to the Kate Spade red. So once again, it's a really beautiful, beautiful deep red, but it's not like that candy apple kind of red that you get a little bit more with the Kate Spade. So just to recap, because I want to look at this one more time, this is absolutely, absolutely stunning and beautiful. The leather on this is very plush. It's very, smells wonderful. It's got a very beautiful, a nice thin profile. So just to kind of show you the profile, all the edges are beautifully, beautifully burnished, which I love and appreciate very much with traveler's notebooks. I like them very much to be burnished, and that just means that they have finished edges. They don't have kind of like the loose things kind of hanging off of them. I know some folks really like that. I personally preferred the burnished edges. I just think it gives it a more polished look, and it's just finished really nicely. In regards to the stitching, it's done beautifully. Everything is done very nicely. You can see some natural markings in the leather from where the animal probably had a number or some sort of scarring on the skin. And this leather is just precious. It's just, I love it. Love it. I love everything to be red in here. That was my choice. So if you guys would prefer to have some sort of a contrast stitching, or you want contrast elastics, that's up to you. I really wanted the red. I'm really feeling the red, and I'm loving the red. So again, I have these secretarial pockets here. I really do enjoy the fact that they aren't the length of the notebook. I think that really kind of is going to make a little bit of a difference. I'll let you know as time goes on, but I feel like it's going to make a little bit of a difference to not have the floating pockets be the length of the entire notebook. And these elastics are a must for me. So if you're not going to splurge for the pockets, the floating pockets, the elastics I highly recommend. I think it's a must when you're working in traveler's notebooks, especially if you got one or two notebooks in here. They get a little chunkier and you want them to lay flat. A lot of people use clips and they clip it down. I don't like to do that. I love having the elastic. It's a requirement for me. It's just a must. Having the floating pockets here with these cards on this side, I think is going to work out a lot better than having them on the left-hand side. So overall, I'm beyond thrilled. Welcome to the Traveler's Notebook game, to LeCow. I hope they do really well, because they have some really beautiful work on there. There's some beautiful like honey-colored leathers and darker brown leathers. And they're those leathers, just by looking at them, I've had enough leathers in my hands, just by looking at them, they're all going to be intoxicating in their smells, and they're just going to be great work. And I can't wait to put my 2019 Hobonichi in here. Just can't wait. So thank you so much, Diamond, for sending me this beautiful, beautiful artwork. I am in love. I can't wait to start using it. I'm just in heaven. I am so in heaven. Go show LeCow some love, and also, of course, let me know what you guys all think. Take care. Bye-bye.